So I packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something to show you how we live. Everybody want it, but it ain't that serious. That's that shit. So if you gon' do it just like this.
So I was right. I took a rash of shit for 2 years, but I was right. And everyone was wrong. And yeah, I got a bonus check for it.
Sue me.
You know? It's a lot of money. I get it. I can feel you judging me. That's palpable. But hey, I never said I was the hero of this story.
Okay, what's going on? So what we're looking at here is weekly Chainlink chart with the SMC 2.0 looking so tidy. I mean, look at this. Just look at the way this is looking. First of all, let's just pay attention to these wicks here. But when I go ahead and put a horizontal ray on this high here, when we put an area on this, you can see the clarity of the price then going down, accumulating, coming up, spiking once, engulfing, spiking twice, moving down, and then we finally break above, stopping just at the level, okay, not giving anything away, and then there's a final push higher. So now that we're at this final, like this upper level, we've come down and we're testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wicks there. This is a lower risk area than say buying up here, but this is a nice spot. So moving down into the daily, you can see some order blocks here. We're very nice. You know, it's very nice. You can see this fair value gap come down, spike once, spike twice. And on this spot, we've seen a bullish engulfing occur. Okay, so this is around the same spot where that resistance lies. And you can see we've come down, fulfilled a bear trap. STM system chart, I've got this bear trap kind of labeled up here. You can see on a replay, price is moving up, we get a move down and forms this wick, and after this wick is formed, we've got this high to low. Again, we've got this range, so when we start to play candle by candle, we have range high, range low, and price moves up, tags liquidity, and closes directly underneath. Okay, this candle, like I was just saying, it doesn't give anything away, and these are advanced market makers doing this. Price pushes up into a new area and then closes down underneath that previous range high. Okay, so that is not a good sign at all. So we could potentially see the range, lower range, get visited. And this is what I was talking about a bear trap. We're visiting this low, and as you can see again, we've got a low tagged on this prior candle, closed inside. That would have been an entry, okay? But again, the advanced level of these market makers, they know there's going to be stop losses under this low because the low's been tagged, the liquidity's been taken, and they know there's going to be another area of liquidity there, and they take that too. So, kind of like what they've done here. So this is kind of like the eraser pattern, the E9 eraser pattern that I shared, and we've got that. But now we've got a nice bullish engulfing, and this is a nice spot. Price underneath the scalper level, not great. Trend switch to downside, not great. But we could see a move back up, and this is what we're saying. We've only got this range to work with. We are in a uptrend, as you can see, and this could be about to turn around. We've got the hour 4 overwatch trend, 7, 8, 9 switched. So we're turning around. Okay, so up here, we've got the higher time frame. Scalper trends, pretty much all switching up to the upside. So this is the last one to switch up, as you can see. So that's why I'm saying it's good. The rest have switched up. It's just the daily that hasn't yet. All the STM are down at the moment, but we can see the levels here. So 1926 is the next one, which is around this particular spot. So all it does needs to do is push up, and then these will start turning. Now we're looking at the whale chart, and you can see a lot cleaner. Okay, so we've got some potential entries here in our whale area down here, down at $17. We've held it. Okay, we've moved up with some nice wicks. Look at this wick here, this wick, and then bam, and then another wick, and bam. We've come and touched this whale area. Look at that, exactly. And we've got a bullish engulfing after that. Now we're back above the scalper level. So the point is, just moving down into this lower level, trying to find a cleaner entry, if there is one. There's always going to be a cleaner entry, but hey, man. You know, I just like to get it over and done with, move on to the next one. And if we look at this hourly chart, you can see this area where the accumulating here again moves down into the same area, again moves down into the same area. So maybe around the 1775 area, but it already has come down. Looks like a bit of a head and shoulders here. We could see the move up. So I'm not a big fan of trend lines, but we can see there is a trend line here. And from the previous link trades, you know, we can see that it breaks a retest and then the enter. So maybe some scaling, scale here, maybe some scale on the break, or scale here and scale back down a bit lower. Depends on what you want to do. But how we're going to do, we're going to do it now, move on to the strategy of what I'm going to do. So here I've got a portion of link tokens that I put in here. So what I'm planning on doing here is that, you know, there's 30 odd K located in this AVE account, call it 9K's worth of liabilities. And, you know, we've got a potential opportunity to borrow a bit more liquidity here, okay, during this time of this retracement. So what I'm going to do is going to go ahead and do this transaction. So show you how easy it is. Just show you. So I consider the link price just currently at the moment while I'm looking at it. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and use the USDT, because that's the smallest percentage at the moment. So we'll go ahead and borrow 5k, okay, and you can see the health factor is moving down to 1.49. so when we borrow the USDT, $26, that's actually quite cheap, man. I remember before I was borrowing the USDT, borrowing tokens, and they were up maybe $50-$60, so just be aware of that. Okay, so that's all gone through now. You can see there's 5k there, and you can see the 5k just located here. Now we could just put this into this put it into the AVE marketplace and earn like 4.81% straight up. In my experience, it's not great. So the plan is buy link.
That is without a doubt the dumbest thing I've ever heard. You are a fucking idiot.
And right here, you've got $5,000 transferred to 271 link for $3.60. I'm gonna do it quick because sometimes that disappears. So quite essentially, we're swapping that for $3.50 instead of like $12. So that's been approved now, and you just need to come to your wallet and just to confirm it and swap that. And that's just cost me $3.60 to swap $5,000. Well, let's do it all in one. About $26 to borrow the money, call it $3.50 to swap. So for all in all, under $30, I've borrowed, we've got the link, and job done. So I already had about 700 in here, so I've got 1,000 link in the wallet. Now, so essentially we've got 30K's worth of link inside of the protocol, okay? Now the health factor is $1.49. And when you see about the risk details here, you can see the liquidation value happens at one. I've got all these link tokens here. And if I click supply and put in the link tokens that I just had, 271 was it, that will boost the health factor up to 1.74. I mean, damn, if you put all of it in there, it will move it up to 2.45. So that needs to be managed, okay? That's why it's best to buy it on a retracement. But essentially here, we've got a big portion of link. We'll put it in there. If it continues to move down, we'll just keep it in the wallet. At any time, we could sell it, okay? And then basically pay off these loans, okay, using our systems, okay. But for the long haul, you could just put it in there. And also, if I come to repay this using my collateral, so let's say you pay off 5k with the link that I've got here, look at the fee. It's nearly $50 just to switch it. But if I was just to use the stuff I've got sitting in my wallet, switch it straight away, the instant cost me a fraction of the price, and then can pay off.
Well, I get it. It's very clever.
Thank you.
How's that working out for you?
What?
Being clever.
Okay, so we're looking at AVAX now, and AVAX could be a good one. I remember when the price was down here, man. I can't believe I didn't buy any. But look at these two little baby whales down there. Baby whales, two of them down under $10. And we get a 500+ percent move. We do have a Daily Divergence, which isn't good, but, you know, I'm not going to sell everything. Sorry, it's Weekly Divergence. So just a quick peek at the monthly chart. You can see that bear trap, like we was talking about. Bam. Right there. Look at that. You can see a clean bear trap there. Moves down, closes back inside. And then we've got a bullish engulfing there on the monthly candle. And then bam, bam, bam. Look at that. So that's nice. So what I'm looking at here is we're looking to get an entry into AVAX because we're basically going to do exactly the same thing as what we did. So essentially looking for some entries here. I mean, it doesn't look great at this particular point. We do have these whale signals, you know, pushes up, bearish engulfing, pushes up again, bearish engulfing. I just can't tell at all. So maybe wait for a move down into the 40s, maybe. Maybe revisiting this high. So somewhere in around this wick area would be a good place. So all I'm going to suggest is simply getting the AVAX, coming over to the Avalanche version of Aave and doing exactly the same thing. Obviously, using a strategy to enter is a lot better than just, you know, hammering at this. But just to let you know, I had 3 AVAX in here from staking rewards. I took that 3 AVAX and borrowed about $100, done the same sketch as what I just did, put it in here, and now I've got 5.75, and I could potentially borrow another $100 and then do the same. But I'm just going to boost it up at the moment just to show you this leveraging. So we've got 13.7 here, we'll supply 13.5. So we put those AVAX in there, and you can see them just here. Okay, so now we've got the collateral inside, and you can see the health factor there flying, 7.72. So we can just go ahead and buy this. So what we're going to do is simply buy every time a whale signal appears. Okay, so when the whale signal appears here, we can simply set an when we set a whale signal alert, when it pops in, like it does come into the server in the E9 Trading Discord, you can simply, as the signal fires off, don't worry about precise entries because you're not leveraged trading, you just let it breathe a bit. Come over to the protocol, click borrow, you know, however much, so about $500 here. Okay, that's gone through. So here you can see we've got current collateral there, 1,000. We've got $500 balance. And we'll just pop over to Uniswap here. You can come into anyone, just switch it to the AVAX chain. Find USD, swap to more AVAX. What I will say is that the more AVAX you build, I mean, we're playing around with Link, okay, cool. We've done a strategy on Link, so this one is about AVAX. So what I'm trying to say is that the more AVAX you build into here, you get it's almost like a staking reward, 1.19%, and you can claim these. So simply swap 500 into AVAX, and that's swapped. And when we go back to the AVE protocol, we can see our AVAX just there. We'll just supply that in. Okay, so now we've got 28.25 AVAX, $1,555. We're getting paid 1.19 APY yield, but we're paying a 6%. So overall, it's like a net APY of minus 1.84. We've got a health factor of 1.89. We need to keep an eye on this. So when you click this notify button, it will open up this, and basically you can set this health factor, you know, alert that you can set up here for whatever chain, the Avalanche chain, pop your address in here below the amount of whatever, you know, 1.4, whatever you want. And then you can click the action, send a Discord message using the webhook, Telegram, email, what have you, and then do it, and it works. So back to this SMC chart, you know, I understand that everybody is not all really up on the SMC in the group. It's not really something that we trade, mainly because it's just too complex for people to grasp onto.
The opening price on Sunday. So those two price points there, there's a difference, even though we see it trade back up to it here.
Out there running around saying they could beat my ass in trading.
And I think today we're going to focus on a double top and double bottom, equal lows, equal highs, which is probably one of my favorites. So what we're looking at here is just the historic details from this indicator. We've got here this EQL, okay? And this is basically the equal lows. And you can see the performance rate here is very, very powerful signal. And it's one to keep an eye on. You know, nice entry patterns. So you can see a double bottom here. There's a double top there. They're going to be the first set of signals that are set up in this new kind of smart money concept channel. Okay, so I'm going to build out the different strategies with the different channels and the different alert mechanisms, and they will come into the Discord server like we did before. You know, this is a lot more complex than the whale system. You know, how do you enter? There's so many different ways you can use this. So over the course of different videos, might do a little video course. We'll just play by ear and build it out. So here we've got the different double bottom types, as you can see. So you've got the Adam bottoms, which are quite narrow, and then the Eve bottoms are like wider and more round looking. And Eve bottoms may also contain price spikes. The general look of them are more rounded. So as you can see here, you know, spiking down, spiking down here. But this is more of an Eve bottom, and this one is more of an Adam bottom. So this is an Adam top. This is an Adam top. This is a Eve bottom, Adam bottom, Adam bottom, and so on. So, you know, rounded, Eve, curvy, Adam, pointy. So we can see by the top left one, the top left example, Adam top, double bottom, is kind of like this one. And the same here, okay, with the equal high, two Adam tops. And you can see the different performance rate here, okay? So the failure rate is 5%, that's 5%. And then the average rise is 35%. So what Bukowski is saying is that when you're looking at the double bottom, ask yourself, you know, am I looking at two spots that look similar like this, a V-shape and a V-shape? Or am I looking at something like this where it's got a V-bottom and then a rounded type of second bottom? So obviously this is numerous, there's like a triple bottom, quadruple bottom here. But let's just take this one. So we've got a move down, move up, and then a rounded move down, 1, 2, and then rounded, okay? And then we've got a rounded bottom here, up, and then a V bottom. So Eve, so this one is Adam and Eve, and this one is Eve and Adam. So they're just different types. So just identifying the different types will give you different performance rates, and that's pretty much that. So here's an example here. You can see the equal lows got printed just there, and you can see the message. Okay, that's what it's going to look like when it comes into the signal channel or something like that. Okay, so that's the double bottoms cleared up for the new SMC signals. I'll do another section on the next video. So just a note on the Discord, guys, we are back in the Nine Traders Discord, okay, the original Discord that we was located in. We're going to start to build a bit of a following in there now, so please come on in. Everybody's invited. Please come in, you know, put your notifications on the server. We're going to start to build there, and that's where we're going to share the details for the E9 trade server, and we'll move from there. So please come on in. The link will be in the description below. Come on in, introduce yourself, say hi. If you don't talk or anything, we'll assume that you're not active there, and you know, we'll kind of remove from the group if you're not active. So just get active in there, ask some questions, use it. Get ahead and let's make some money. Okay, so skimming over Twitter, oh man, there's so much crap. So much crap out there, it's absolutely crazy. But
I hate this place. This zoo, this prison, this reality, whatever you want to call it. I can't stand it any longer.
You know, I stumbled onto this one coin, okay? It hasn't really gone mad. It's been out for a bit. So we'll just monitor this moving forwards. So I got two. Got this one, Mucky. And we can see here the price. Look at that. So it's been running since kind of before December. It's a base chain, you know, meme coin. We can see this clean price action here. Look at this. But breaking new highs, coming down, retesting old high, new high, retest old high, new high, retest old high. Okay, so we've retested the old high now, move up. So when we start looking at potential, you know, run-ups, start looking at, just head towards like, you know, 1 cent. So this is one that I'm keeping an eye on. We got some decent liquidity there, over a million, which is good. There's a decent audit score there, which is good. When we look at the website, it looks okay. Looks cool, fun. I'm just looking for gaps and, you know, if something's been slapped together, it's not really what we want. You know, gotta appreciate there's different markets for different things like this. And, you know, we just want to see detail, you know, we want to see good, we want to see nice clean detail, good images, etc. And it looks okay. So this is like some childlike branding. So as you can see here, that's pretty much it. So it looks okay. When we look at the Twitter account, okay, cool. Named after Coinbase CEO Cat. So yeah, Twitter looks good. It's more for like, you know, childlike type stuff. But all we're looking for is the upside potential. We can see nice clean price action here. The next one I've got on the cards here is called Toshi, another cat coin on Base Chain. And we simply can see, you know, it's not been out long. It's probably been out a couple of months, a few months. And yeah, nice clean price action. It's just coming down a bit. And it's broken up to new highs. We're coming down retesting. It has come up to this high, so we're going to see what happens from there. But one of the main things is if I was just to just zoom out a bit, I've got log. So we're on log scale. Now what I'm interested in is this wick back here. Okay, this wick peaks out at 0.0067 when we measure the current price to the top of the wick. There, we're looking at nearly 1900%. That is so nice. That is very nice. So these wicks usually give an indication, and we'll make a move from there. So these are just two little things, and we'll pop them on in the next video to see where they are, see whether they got rubbed or not, and see if there's any profits. So that's it. Remember guys, we're rocking in the Discord now, so come on in and get active.
Yeah, dude who's been doing this for 32 years, full-time professional, rated by One Family Magazine, number one clown, 9 straight years.
Jim the Empress!
Don't move your money from Bear, that's just being silly. Don't be silly.
Bear Stearns shares are down 90% this morning.
Listen, Tesla's a sell. You don't want to own this stuff. You don't want to lease it. Heck, you shouldn't even rent the darn thing.
You know, Jim, I'd say, yeah, sure, Jim, you know, we're no Bear Stearns, but I think we're going to do okay. You know, frankly, it's a contraindicator.
I see Netflix coming down. I see competition everywhere in that business. I don't want anything to do with Netflix. I think it is starting to slow.
To me, it's reasonable to compare you, I usually don't do this, to Steve Jobs and what he did for computing.
In a stunning fall from grace, Elizabeth Holmes will spend 11 years behind bars for defrauding investors.
J.P. Morgan, of this generation, Sam Bankman-Fried's FTX.
Prosecutors and his attorneys are requesting that he be allowed a flip phone while out on bail.
If you like me, well then you're a big believer in cryptocurrency and you will want to own Coinbase for the long haul. Then this is a $475 stock.
Why do you think it's been so resilient here in the high 16s?
Well, I'll tell you what Scar says, because it's phony and a scam. And I would sell my Bitcoin right into this rally. SVB's nearly 40% rally this year is barely a drop in the bucket. And that's how I want you to think it. Stock's still cheap.
U.S. regulators have seized a bank the largest to fail since the Great Recession. It's Silicon Valley Bank.
I like to make money. Boring is good. Watch out for Signature Bank. That's my fave. Watch out for Signature Bank. That's my fave.
Signature Bank marks the third largest bank failure in U.S. history.
What did you get wrong?
what though? You my favorite accident. So go ahead, pop some crystal for my newborn child. Cause now, yeah, know what this is. It's a celebration, bitches. Grab a drink.